sort of made it clear to me what was most important and what my goals were, and that was to get a good education and to be able to compete for a national championship every year.
This, swimming lap after lap, thousands of hours staring at a black line on the bottom of a pool. Bob Bowman is his coach.
For about 5 years, he did not take one day off.
Christmas Day?
Nope, we trained on Christmas.
His birthday?
Oh yeah, that's a given, twice on his birthday.
How do you do that every day?
To be honest, it's not wanting to lose, wanting to do something that no one else had ever done before. That's what got me out of bed every day.
The workouts were so intense, Bowman became known as the Mad Scientist.
In the 1990s, one single athlete absolutely dominated the sport of cross-country skiing. As an amazing 9-time world champion, winning a record 8 gold and 4 silver Olympic medals, this exceptional athlete seemed virtually invincible to his competitors. The most successful cross-country skier in the history of the Olympic Winter Games is Bjørn Dalen. Bjørn Dalen awed his fans for a decade and beyond with his psychological and physical strength. His unshakable discipline and systematic approach, which always strengthened his determination to improve his performance. His strong will and dedication to his sport, his commitment to passing on his experience to young athletes and sparking enthusiasm for sports among children have made him one of the greatest and most inspiring athletes of all time.
Things like that, that would stagger them, and he would go in and out of them for hours at a time, just in and out. He would never, ever tire. And I had a floodlight in the backyard, and his mother would say, "Walter, would you please go bring him in the house? It's 10 o'clock. The neighbors are going to think we're all crazy in this house."
You know, you get the puck and you go around a pylon. It was always, you know, Gordie Howe goes around the defenseman, scores a winning goal in the Stanley Cup. We all did that. That's what it was all about.
Even when he was a little boy, you could tell he was going to be special. The first year he ever played, he was 6 years old. The youngest traveling team we had at that time were 10-year-old boys. He made that team. He scored one goal that year. 4 years later, for that same team, he scored 378. And these were 10-minute straight time periods.
Well, there was a small article in the newspaper saying how Michael was tired of taking a physical abuse from the Detroit Pistons and wanted to start a strength and conditioning program, but he was afraid to lift any weights because he didn't know what the effects were going to be on his game. And I actually contacted the team physician and the athletic trainer at that time, met with both of them to explain my philosophies, and they introduced me to Michael. And Michael said, you know, we'll try it out for 30 days, and 30 days turned into 15 years. Michael's mindset into training was extremely unique. I mean, the most competitive individual I've ever met, never wanted to lose at anything, always felt like somebody else was going to outwork him, so he wanted to outwork them, knew what his weaknesses were, knew what his strengths were. He had a big thing where he used to say, "Hey, listen, I'm going to turn my weaknesses into strengths," and he did. And what you notice is every year there was evolution in his game. There was something that he added, whether it was a new shot, a new move. He was never satisfied, no matter how many championships, how many titles, what people said, how many accolades he got. He always wanted to get better.
Yeah, he's got even his sights now. He's got the encouragement to go. And surely, it looks as if he's going to catch him. Jones kicks hard in front. And can he hang on? Sanger coming with every score. And the African is going to steal his place. But Jones coming back. And Barber's got it. And Jones comes back on the inside. And what a finish.
Goals for the beginning of the year: NCAA championship, NESCAC championship, hosting NESCAC. The school never won NESCAC championship in the tournament. We never advanced past, I don't think, the quarterfinals in NCAA, so those were the big three up there.
More important to me, more important to our program is, how are we doing it? How are we doing it every day? What are we doing every day to achieve those goals? Certainly winning our league is a goal every day.
Knowing we have a great team, ton of talent, and we had a great offseason, everything seemed to be going in the right direction.
Up! Down! Down! Go! Up! Down! Down!
Almost in.
Drop them!
There's no team in the country that's outworking you.
It's my Super Bowl.
Our Super Bowl.
The day before the championship game, we had a practice at M&T Bank Stadium. We had like an hour slot, but we got there really early. We were actually in the Ravens locker room.
How hard would you go if it was your last game?
It is.
We gotta play together as one. If we play together, we will be happy. All right, keep it simple.
We take it one at a time, one possession at a time. Here we go, baby. Everything we do together. Together on three. One, two, three,
together!
Our warriors are on our left, as we have all year long.
Dominate on three! One, two, three!
Dominate!
Let's go!
Yeah.
What is it?
It's a spectacular day for NCAA lacrosse. Temperatures right around 90 degrees here at M&T Bank Stadium as the fans file in. Let's take a closer look. Coming up next, the Division III National Championship. We mentioned Tufts. They have never won an NCAA championship in a men's sport. Streaking in. The eight-time champs here. Dominant 6-1.
What has it?
In front, it scores! The pass! With 5 seconds left, and that will do it! For the first time in school history, in any sport, Tufts has won the Division III National Championship! Can you believe the Jumbos? History is...
Does it again!
Always there to break my fall, and now I find the comfort to see through it all.
Hands are weak, hands are shaking, I can't breathe, so give me the drive!